Stephen and Lora, as we get ready to exchange, as you get ready to exchange your vows to one another, I want to say to you that this word vow is a very significant word. It's more than a promise. It's really a covenant, not only between the two of you, but between you, the two of you and God. It's a covenant that is meant to never be broken, a covenant that's meant to be everlasting. And so these words carry more than just sentiment to them. They carry the weight of all that you are and all that you bring to this moment. So Stephen, as with those thoughts in mind, I'm going to ask you to face your bride and repeat after me. In the name of God.
Start now.
Start now. I, Stephen, take you, Lora, to be my wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish until we are parted by death. This is my solemn vow. Lora, you to Stephen. In the name of God.
In the name of God.
I, Lora, take you, Stephen.
I, Lora, take you, Stephen.
Be my husband. To have and to hold from this day forward. For better, for worse. For richer, for poorer. In sickness and in health. To love and to cherish. Until we are parted by death. This is my solemn vow. The wedding ring is an outward and visible sign of an inward and spiritual grace. God has given us His love, an eternal love that never ends. His wedding rings symbolize that eternal love. They don't have a beginning, they don't have an end. Neither does God's love. So our goal is to exemplify that love. These symbols remind us of that. I want to pray together for these rings. Father, we thank you for this moment. We thank you for this couple. We pray blessings on them as they come to this moment and stand before you and stand before this congregation. And we ask you to bring blessings. We ask you to bring promise. We ask you to bring all that you want, all that you desire into this covenant. And we trust it into your hands. In your name we pray. Amen. Stephen, if you'll take Laura's ring and place it on her finger. Lora, I give you this ring as a sign of my vow, with all that I am and all that I have.
I honor you.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Repeat after me. Stephen, I give you this ring. As a sign of my vow, with all that I am and all that I have, I honor you. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Stephen and Laura have chosen to use the sand ceremony as a symbol of their coming together. The sand is different colors mingled from different places, and it represents their two lives no longer being one, or being two, but becoming one, and symbolizing the differences they bring to make something beautiful. You've declared your consent and vows before God and before this congregation. May God confirm your covenant and fill you both with His grace. Now that Laura and Stephen have given themselves to each other by solemn vows, for the joining of hands and the giving and receiving of rings, I announce to you that they are husband and wife. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, those whom God has joined together, let no one put asunder. Stephen, you may kiss your bride. Gentlemen, it gives me great privilege and pleasure for the very first time to introduce to you Mr. and Mrs. Stephen Scarboro.